Welcome back to ProLine. Last week, we saw TCU demolish Utah. Now, we hear all the pundits on TV talk about the BCS, and the BCS is one thing. It's bullshit. Absolute bullshit. The way they do the ratings, TCU falls here. They beat a number five team in the country, and they don't move up to number one or two? Give me a break. Auburn would get crushed by TCU. TCU has so many defensive NFL draft choices on their team, they shut down everybody. When was the last time they gave up more than 7 points? Absolutely. Now, talk about, let's go back to Texas and talk about Dallas Cowboys. They fire Wade Phillips. Do you really think Wade Phillips was the only problem the Dallas Cowboys have? And they move up an assistant coach to being coach? He was part of the culture. If they want to change things down there, you got to get rid of all those coaches and change the culture.
But you got to change the owner.
Well,
no. You're not going to do that.
They've got a good owner.
He's won a Super Bowl before.
Good owner.
No, he's not.
He's a terrific owner.
He's not, and I'll tell you why he's not. He isn't. Look, what he needs to do is step back. What he needs to do is what Steinbrenner did years ago with the Yankees, which was stop trying to make believe he knows as much as real NFL player personnel guys. He needs to step back and be an owner like Robert Kraft. Stop hogging the spotlight. Stop trying to think you're the football guru. And let's real football
though.
People take over.
Jerry Jones is a real football. He played at Arkansas.
I know
Jerry
he played
Jones
at Arkansas.
Knows the game. George Steinbrenner didn't play in the NFL. I mean, in the Major League Baseball.
Well, it's not all about playing it, but the problem is that Jones won't listen to anybody. It's been a huge.
I'm not going to knock a guy who's won three Super Bowls.
Exactly. He ran Jimmy Johnson out of there, and they haven't won a whole lot since Jerry. What have they won? One playoff game in the last decade.
Hey, that's more than a lot of teams. You know, you knock the Dallas Cowboys, and you look at a lot of franchises around the NFL that haven't had that kind of success. You know, it's tough in the NFL to win Super Bowls, and Dallas has won three. I'm not going to, you know, pile on Jerry Jones
right
now.
The big problem I see is these are professional athletes, professional coaches getting paid a lot of money. Arguably, they had the best talent in the league going into the season, and a lot of people were saying, this is the team that's going to be in the Super Bowl. They quit. They don't even try.
That's a
disaster. That means your entire culture is decayed and poisoned.
But this is why I think you give the job to, you know, Jason Garrett, why it's a smart move, because now you can see how he does the rest of the year, and you don't have to invest a long-term contract in Jason Garrett, you know, for 2011 if he stinks up the joint for the rest of this year.
That's the one reason I agree with the move, because they can give him the rest.
Good point.
Without giving him a long-term contract to do so. And you know, I mean, but it's not just the Dallas Cowboys this week. I mean, we had a college firing on Monday or Tuesday with Dan Hawkins finally gone from the Colorado campus. You know, that Boise State stuff that we've seen out of Dirk Cutter, when he was at Boise, then he took the job at Arizona State, they flopped. He's been an assistant ever since. Dan Hawkins brings that mentality to the Big 12. It ain't going to work. I heard somebody the other day saying, you know, if he was already in the Pac-10, he probably would have had success. Well, what does that say about the Pac-10? Because in the Big 12, they read Dan Hawkins' playbook like a book, and he just had a horrible time of it. They're talking about bringing Bill McCartney back at 70 years of age. Bill McCartney did a great job. There were also some strange things going on in Colorado football with a lot of the recruiting that was going on back then. You mentioned TCU and the defensive NFL future for some of these players. They've got more defensive players on that team right now than the Houston Texans.
Oh, that's for sure. I mean, the Houston Texans, they're one of the worst defensive teams in the NFL. We're going to come right back. We have two great college games to talk about and two pro games. Stay tuned. Last week's high-end tripleheader went 3-0. Navy a winner. Arkansas winner. Arizona-Stanford over a winner. I told you I was going to go 3-0, and I did. This weekend gets even better. Five big games, just $5. That's right, a buck a play, including both my college and pro games of the month. Hammer home five big winners for just a buck a play. Call toll-free right now, 1-866-841-1655. And don't forget, for free plays each and every day, text to your phone, just text WINNER. That's WINNER to 313131. Let's have a huge weekend together. Call right now, 1-866-841-1655, and text WINNER to 313131.
on fire. Hey, guys, it's Alan McMorty here, the 34-time handicapping champion. Last week, we did it again, cashing with the Penn State Nittany Lions. That was our Fortune 500 Club College Football Game of the Year. We're now at documented 10-1 this season on our TV offers. And what do we do for an encore? Today, I'm releasing my one and only NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. This play is sold online for $500, but right here, you get it for just $25. Call right now, toll-free, 866-896-1620. 28. This play is out of a system that's 25-0 going back 31 years. The 26th win in a row as their NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. We go to 11-1 on our TV offers with this huge monster winner. Call right now, toll free, 866-896-1628. Just $25, 866-896-1628. Our NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. Call now.
Welcome back. We've got Texas A&M at Baylor. Now, Baylor kind of messed up last week. They didn't. Scott was talking about it. He beat them last week. They didn't come to play. Now, the week before, they clinched a bowl game. And they have played like 11 straight weeks without a break. I don't know. Have this team let down? Because they're in a tough spot here against a team that's coming off that Oklahoma victory. Scott?
I'll tell you what. You said they disappointed? Not a Smash Mouth Sports. They did just what we hoped they would. They lost 55-28. We cashed that morning massacre game of the year on Oklahoma State. This particular football game, I think I understand public perception, but I think the wrong team's favored. I don't think A&M should be laying points here in Waco. First of all, A&M has played better the last three games since they brought in Ryan Tannehill, the quarterback. First two games, he was outstanding. 72% completion rate and an outstanding 7-1 touchdown to INT ratio. He came down to earth a little bit against a better Oklahoma team last week, and I think he hit about 59% of his passes. Not bad, but not great. And he had two picks to go along with his two touchdowns. He was also sacked three times. And here's the thing about it, though, for me. I think the jury's still out on him, on Tannehill. But when you watch that game last week, Oklahoma did it again. They beat themselves for the second time this season. Now, as of Wednesday morning, they were still talking about the crowd cheering Wrecking Crew for the first time in a decade and a half at College Station. It's like they're caught up in that game that happened last week. A few weeks ago, Missouri beat Oklahoma. They were going crazy on campus. I went against Missouri when they went to Lincoln the very next week. 2 weeks ago, Baylor knocks off Texas for the first time since about 1908, and not that long. And then Baylor, of course, goes on the road, and we take Oklahoma State, and they thrash Baylor. I think A&M is the hungover team this week, guys. I'm going to back the Baylor Bears on this one, plus the points.
Well, I am as well, and I agree with everything you said. I also, you know, it's funny, you get in the zone sometimes with teams. That's the way it's been for me in the Big 12 this year, especially involving these teams. Been getting a lot of winners with A&M, Baylor, Oklahoma State. And last week, Oklahoma State and A&M were my two biggest personal service plays. Now, I don't mean to turn this into a promo spot, but I think I've got these teams nailed. Oklahoma State was just in a great spot last week. They match up really well with Baylor, too. That's part of it. A lot of the things that Baylor does well, Oklahoma State does better than they do. Oklahoma State's a little better team. A&M, as much as I loved them last week against Oklahoma, that game was going the opposite way in the third quarter. They had lost all their steam in that game, and I thought it was a really bad gamble on Oklahoma's part, which did not work out, and it turned the game back in A&M's direction, which I was really happy about. But boy, you hit the nail on the head, Scott. They are really celebrating this win down at the College Station. I think they're going to have trouble here. And my power ratings on a neutral field, A&M's just a one-point favorite. You put it on in Waco, especially off the letdown situation. I think Baylor should be the favorite in this football game. It's the other way around, Al. You're getting points here. I think it's a bargain with Baylor.
Yeah. Now, have you guys ever been to Waco, Texas? I mean, there's not much to do in Waco. If you want to drink beer, you go to George's. If you want a milkshake, you go to the health camp. And that's pretty much all you can do in Waco, Texas. So these kids really, you know, like to play well at home. They've won all four home games this season. You know, Dave and Scott have made all the points. I really can't add much to that. I will say this from a technical perspective. Texas A&M is in its worst point spread role this week. On the road, off a home win versus 700 or better opponents, A&M now 0-14 in the last 14. I'm not going to go against that. Baylor also falls into a tremendous system that's 72-29 against the spread that plays on certain teams off a 21-point or worse conference defeat. We're going to take Baylor in this ball game. Point spread's way off here. Take Baylor plus the points. Jim?
That's the interesting thing about handicapping. You look at the game from all different sides. I mean, you look at the fact that Baylor has clinched their bowl game. You look at A&M coming off the big game. You talk the technicals, the fundamentals. That's what makes handicapping, rather than the science, it's really an art. We're going to come back with more art. We've got Virginia Tech and North Carolina.
Hi, everybody. Scott Spritzer from Smash Mouth Sports. Hope you were with us last weekend as we started off the weekend with our morning massacre game of the year, and it was just that. Massacre start to finish. Oklahoma State, 55-28 over Baylor, came back on Sunday, and we cashed with the San Diego Chargers, our SmackDown game of the year in the pros. Well, it's here. It is my 15th annual college football game of the year. We've gone 12-2, 86% with these plays. Lifetime. You don't want to miss out. That's how we start off the weekend. It's only $25. You'll get Sunday's pros for free. You'll get the rest of November in college basketball also free. 2 years ago, we sat right here on ProLine and told you about our 33-6 college basketball start. Last year, 36-16. You don't want to miss out on numbers like that. All you have to do is call toll-free, 1-866-896-1627. College football game of the year weekend, only $25. 1-866-896-1627.
Hi, everyone. Dave Koken. And you know, there's an element of chance in every game that you play. But I can tell you, and I'm not stretching this, the game I'm using for my mismatch of the year has less gamble involved in it than any game I've seen probably in 2 or 3 years. This game is going to be an annihilation. Awesome scheduling dynamics, perfect situation. That's why it's my mismatch of the year. The first thing you got to do, though, get my 3 free TV games today, and what a lineup. South Carolina, Florida, Utah, Notre Dame, USC, Arizona, they're all free on tape right now. 1-888-633-1710 is the number to call. That's 1-888-633-1710. And then find out how to get my mismatch of the year, a personal service exclusive. This will not be available online anyplace. Again, the number to call right now to get the free TV winners on tape, 1-888-633-1710.
This is an interesting game. Virginia Tech and North Carolina. North Carolina, of course, started the season off with lots of suspensions. All that bull was going on. They've come back to play pretty well so far this year. Virginia Tech starts off against Boise, and then they lose to James Madison. Two losses right there. Now, they both came back. Now, Virginia Tech has now won 7 games in a row. Favorite in this game at North Carolina. Big game, Dave.
It is, and I just sat here and told you how awesome I've done with those Big 12 teams. Not so awesome with Virginia Tech. They've been a little bit of a problem for me to handicap. I had them last week against Georgia Tech, and I thought, quite honestly, they should have run them off the field. Instead, they dug themselves a hole, and they managed to win the game. But I wasn't impressed. That's the problem in the ACC. It is a low-grade conference. It's a lousy league. And anybody who thinks that, you know, the ACC team, whoever comes out of there with the automatic bid to the BCS, ditto for the Big East, they're going to have big trouble in their bowl game. Virginia Tech, they're the best team in the ACC. That league's in trouble. In North Carolina, tough to figure because they've been on kind of a roller coaster all year. And for me, and I hate to just pass games, but that's what I'm kind of do here. I just can't get a good feel for it. So why invest in something where you don't have a good opinion?
Well, there's 50 games on the board. You can pick and choose. So we don't have to play every game.
Yeah, I'm not saving. It's not. I'm saving this for my personal service customers. No, I'm not. I'm just not playing this game at all.
Well, you know, I'm going to step in and take the underdog here, the home dog. You know, Virginia Tech, it happens every year. Every year a team gets anointed as the team that's playing the best at the end of the season. And what that really means is the team didn't play well in the games that counted.
Yeah, exactly.
And they only played well in the games that didn't matter anymore. So that's this Virginia Tech team here. We went against Virginia Tech last week. We actually took Georgia Tech, had a nice win on that weekday game. I'm going to go against Virginia Tech again here. North Carolina comes into this ballgame off a big upset win. They win by 2 points at Florida State as 11-point underdogs. And one of the things I like to do is take unrested home dogs of plus 4 or more points if they're off a road win as an underdog of more than 4, as you know, when they were installed as an underdog in that ballgame as more than 4 points. These teams now 32-11 against the spread versus conference foes, provided they also won 2 games back. I'm not going to go against a 32-11 stat. I'll take the points with the home dog Tar Heels. Scott?
I had the same play as you, that Thursday night game with Georgia Tech over Virginia Tech, and I'm with you again with North Carolina. That Thursday night game, by the way, Virginia Tech won by 6. They were laying double figures in the contest, and they're very fortunate to have won that game outright. If you remember, Nesbitt, the quarterback for Georgia Tech, was about ready to turn that into a 21-7 Yellow Jacket lead at the end of the first half. He got hurt. He throws a pick inside the 10-yard line. Virginia Tech is able to parlay all of that because Nesbitt never came back in the game in the second half. They were able to parlay it into a victory, but Georgia Tech got the money. I'm not crazy about this Frank Beamer addition in Blacksburg, and I think now they're going to go on the road. And North Carolina, remember, folks, before all the crap that happened off the field, before all the suspensions that took place, as far as I'm concerned, this was a top five football team going into this season if they wouldn't have done what they did away from the field. They still got some pretty good talent. Now, they did lose the running back, but T.J. Yates is having a tremendous year. 66% passer, 15-4 touchdown to INT ratio. Six players on this team, Jim, are averaging between 12 and 23 yards per catch. I think there's too much firepower on North Carolina. They're still flying under the radar, and I'm going to go ahead and back the Tar Heels. I'm going to agree with Al on this one.
Well, I would side with North Carolina as well. They're playing very well. Home dog situation. I know Virginia Tech, Beamer, all that stuff. I mean, they're 7 in a row. It's hard to go against. But if I was going to play this game, I'm going to play the underdog. But I'll tell you what, we've got the NFL coming up. We got the Jags hosting the Texans, and we got the Bears hosting the Vikings. Be right back.
On fire. Hey, guys, it's Al McMorty here, the 34-time handicapping champion. Last week, we did it again, cashing with the Penn State Nittany Lions. That was our Fortune 500 Club college football game of the year. We're now a documented 10-1 this season on our TV offers. And what do we do for an encore? Today, I'm releasing my one and only NFL Fortune 500 Club game of the year. This play is sold online for $500, but right here, you get it for just $25. Call right now, toll-free, 866-896-1620. This play is out of a system that's 25-0 going back 31 years. The 26th win in a row as their NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. We go to 11-1 on our TV offers with this huge monster winner. Call right now, toll free, 866-896-1628. Just $25, 866-896-1628. Our NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. Call now.
Hi, everybody. Scott Spritzer from Smash Mouth Sports. Hope you were with us last weekend as we started off the weekend with our morning massacre game of the year, and it was just that. Massacre start to finish. Oklahoma State, 55-28 over Baylor, came back on Sunday, and we cashed with the San Diego Chargers, our SmackDown game of the year in the pros. Well, it's here. It is my 15th annual college football game of the year. We've gone 12-2, 86% with these plays. Lifetime. You don't want to miss out. That's how we start off the weekend. It's only $25. You'll get Sunday's pros for free. You'll get the rest of November in college basketball also free. 2 years ago, we sat right here on ProLine and told you about our 33-6 college basketball start. Last year, 36-16. You don't want to miss out on numbers like that. All you have to do is call toll-free, 1-866-896-1627. College football game of the year weekend, only $25. 1-866-896-1627.
Jacksonville, they have a week off. Coming off the Dallas victory, of course, now everybody beats Dallas because they don't even show up. I don't, who knows what's going on with the Dallas Cowboys. Houston, on the other hand, this is a very disappointing team to me and a lot of other people. Every year, everybody says, this is the team, this is the year, they're going to come back, and they're going to have a good year because they got so much talent. Well, on offense, their offense does show up, but their defense is 29th in the league, Al.
Yeah, Jim, you know what's interesting about this Houston Texans team? They've only covered two games this season. Those are the two games they held their opponents to 24 points. In their other six games, they've given up at least 27 points, and they haven't covered the spread in any of those ball games. I can't side with this Houston Texans team. Jacksonville had its bye week last week, and that's a big deal in certain situations in the NFL. And if you take a look at how 500 or better teams do off the bye week, they cover the spread 63% of the time. If they're not laying at least 13 points and their opponent's off a straight-up loss, I've got to take the Jacksonville Jaguars here. Dave?
Well, here's the thing that has always confused me about football coaches. If you find something that really works, why do you go away from it before the other team has figured out a way to stop it? They're going to win that game last week, much to my disappointment, by the way, because I had a big play on the Chargers. And I'm going to lose the football game. And then they just, you know what, Arian Foster's really running it well. Let's not use him anymore. And let's try and give it. What do you, Kubiak just, I just don't like the decisions he's making with this squad. I think they are squarely underachieving at this point. This is a more talented team than they're showing in the win-loss column. And I think going on the road off a really disappointing pair of losses, the Colts game, Monday Night Football game, they were geared up for that, laid an egg. Another bad game at home against San Diego last week. I think they've got the losing mentality that they're used to having in Houston. This is why they don't make the playoffs. Ike Kubiak is the next coach in Texas to lose his job. And I think they'll have problems here. Jacksonville's rested. You mentioned that, Al. And I think the Jaguars, well, they're not a great football team. They know how to win the games that they are capable of winning, and I think they're going to win this game.
What I saw, and I had the Chargers too, when I saw the change in the schematics of the Houston Texans after I'd almost counted that as a loss, I was going crazy. I loved it because I knew it gave the Chargers a chance. I'm going to get all Hitchcock-esque here for a second. Can we do that in handicapping?
Good evening.
here's what I'm talking about. We've got, as Jim mentioned, like the fourth worst overall defense in the Houston Texans, worst pass defense. Jacksonville, terrible pass defense, one of the worst in the NFL. Both teams not too hot against the run either, which you think they would have great numbers against the run because everybody passes the heck out of them. David Garrard throws for 1 million yards every time he matches up against this Houston Texans stop unit. Just tears them apart. I'm going under.
What does this have to do with Hitchcock?
That's the Hitchcock-esque turn in the plot.
Oh.
I am taking the under. Look at what Jacksonville has done at home so far this season. They're giving up 12.8 points per game in their whole home games this year. They've held two of their opponents at home to a field goal each. It's been amazing. The Jacksonville Jaguars, if I can speak, and their opponents on their home field are averaging 41 combined total points per game. I think the public's going to jump all over. Oh, this is going to be a 35-31 shootout, and you're going to see the game land in the low 40s. I'm playing the under in this one.
Well, the word came up a few minutes ago about being contrarian in the NFL, and absolutely, being a contrarian against anything the public thinks is always going to win you money. There's no question, because the bookmakers are not there to go broke and build you a house. It just
really?
Doesn't happen that way. They bought a big number on this game. Now, you know, I'm a pretty good total player, but when you see a 50 on this game with two teams like this, I mean, they're schizophrenic teams. I mean, like Dave said, the coach can come out, he can run the ball against good defensive run teams and not pass against the weak. And who knows what these guys are doing? Jacksonville's not a good team. They're not, and Houston is not a good team. I don't know what to do with the total. I'm staying away from it, but I would be contrarian if I was going to do anything with it. We'll be right back. We got Minnesota and the Bears.
Hi, everyone. Dave Koken. And, you know, there's an element of chance in every game that you play. But I can tell you, and I'm not stretching this, the game I'm using for my mismatch of the year has less gamble involved in it than any game I've seen probably in 2 or 3 years. This game is going to be an annihilation. Awesome scheduling dynamics, perfect situation. That's why it's my mismatch of the year. The first thing you got to do, though, get my 3 free TV games today. And what a lineup. South Carolina, Florida, Utah, Notre Dame, USC, Arizona. They're all free on tape right now. 1-888-633-1710 is the number to call. That's 1-888-633-1710. And then find out how to get my mismatch of the year. A personal service exclusive. This will not be available online anyplace. Again, the number to call right now to get the free TV winners on tape, 1-888-633-1710.
Last week's high-end triple header went 3-0. Navy a winner. Arkansas a winner. Arizona Stanford over a winner. I told you I was going to go 3-0, and I did. This weekend gets even better. 5 big games, just $5. That's right, $1 a play, including both my college and pro games of the month. Hammer home 5 big winners for just $1 a play. Call toll-free right now, 1-866-841-1655. And don't forget, for free plays each and every day, text to your phone, just text WINNER. That's W-I-N-N-E-R to 313131. Let's have a huge weekend together. Call right now, 1-866-841-1655, and text WINNER to 313131. Okay, we're back. We got the Vikings visiting the Bears. Now, this is a great old rivalry. Well, let's look at what these teams did last week. The Bears went up to Toronto, and they did beat Buffalo. But Buffalo, you know, they come to play pretty hard every week. They're trying. They don't win, but they are trying very hard. The Bears did win the game, but the stats, the way they played, I'm not that impressed. I'm not impressed with the way Mike Martz is calling the plays. The offensive line for the Bears is very weak, gives up a lot of sacks. Now, Minnesota, on the other hand, did not look good. Even though they had a ton of stats, they were down 14 points, but then they came back, and Brett Favre was amazing at the end. He is an amazing quarterback. We have our issues with him. The media knocks him all the time, but the guy can play football. I'm not going to say too much about Childress because it doesn't look like he really is a coach that most people would want as a head coach. But the Minnesota Vikings are going to go on a run now, and this is going to start right here in this game. Dave?
Well, I don't know if they're going to go on a run or not. I think they're a mess, and their special teams are awful. And that's a big problem. Yeah, it's the most overlooked thing in the NFL is special teams. If you're a Charger fan, you know what I'm talking about, because the San Diego Chargers have basically destroyed their season with their horrendous special teams play. Minnesota completely outplayed Arizona last week, but nearly gave the game away because of awful special teams play. You keep on making those mistakes, it's going to cost you football games. The Bears are one of the worst-looking 5-3 teams you'll ever see. The offensive line is hideous. Cutler continues to make bad decisions. I don't know. They're just not a very good football team. My thoughts here are that this game's staying under the total unless you get a couple of special team scores, which is a possibility, I suppose, Scott. But I'm going to look for the Vikings and Bears to have an old, I guess you can call it an old rivalry battle, but to me it's just two teams that aren't really very good and won't score much.
The old black and blue Norris division is what you're looking for here. You know, when I look at this particular football game, first of all, you're right. I was glad Brett Favre came back because he's the most exciting personality in the NFL. Just don't give him your text number. But in this particular football game, you know, if you look back to when Chicago played, sorry about that, when Chicago played Green Bay on that Monday Night Football game, I had the Bears in that contest, and Chicago came back and got the win. We're very happy about that, but we saw some alarming issues with Jay Cutler and this Mike Martz offense, and I remember post-game, a lot of the announcers and the talking heads on TV, oh, Jay Cutler, wow, what a fit with this Mike Martz offense. And I'm sitting there thinking, wow, he almost threw about four or five picks in there that could have gone the other way and changed that game. I felt fortunate to win the contest. Since that win against Green Bay, this Bears offense has stunk on ice. Five games now, they're averaging less than 15 first downs per game. They're averaging less than 254 total yards per game. Under 55% passing. Now, most of that, not all of that is Jay Cutler because he missed some time. Most of that is him. How about in the last five games, 3 touchdown passes, 10 interceptions, 24 sacks allowed in 5 games. It's hard to blame Jay Cutler. Here's the bottom line. Minnesota finally got off the schneid, getting to the quarterback last week. They had 6 sacks in that game. They outgained Arizona, Al, by some 300 yards. Had to be lucky on Brett Favre's arm to come back and win the game, but I think they make it 2 straight. I like them here.
Yeah, well, I think great minds think alike. I'm going to side with Jim and Scott in this ball game. The Minnesota Vikings are installed as a 1-point road favorite here, and if you take a look at how teams have done over the past 8 seasons, losing teams that are pick'em or favored against a team off a straight-up win, these teams now 98-71 against the spread, including 52-26 if our losing team failed to cover the spread by 4 or more points, which, of course, Minnesota did last week versus the Cardinals. Take Minnesota, lay the 1-point blowout win in Chicago. Jim?
Is stunk on ice like a drink? Like a cocktail?
Well, I hope
I don't want to be at that bar.
I don't know where that came. That was a very interesting comment. Jay Cutler would be a great quarterback in the NFL if he had an offensive line that could protect him. The guy has a ton of talent. I remember him going back to college. Mm-hmm. This kid can play football, but you can't have him on the ground all day. You talk about those sacks, they're terrible. I'm going with the Vikings. Be right back with more football. Last week's high-end tripleheader went 3-0. Navy a winner. Arkansas winner. Arizona Stanford over a winner. I told you I was going to go 3-0, and I did. This weekend gets even better. 5 big games, just $5. That's right, $1 a play, including both my college and pro games of the month. Hammer home 5 big winners for just $1 a play. Call toll-free right now, 1-866-841-1655. And don't forget, for free plays each and every day, text to your phone, just text WINNER. That's WINNER to 313131. Let's have a huge weekend together. Call right now, 1-866-841-1655, and text WINNER to 313131.
My best bet this week, the under between the Texans and Jaguars from Jacksonville. It's here, folks. My 15th annual college football game of the year goes on Saturday, of course, available on Friday All you have to do is call 1-866-896-1627. It's only $25. I'm 12-2, 86% winners lifetime with my 14 college football games of the year. You're also going to get Sunday's pros at no additional cost, the rest of November at no additional cost in college baskets. Again, it's my college football game of the year weekend, just $25. 1-866-896-1627. Dave?
I am going to go with the Baylor Bears. I like them to win this game. At home, I think that's a very nice scheduling spot for them against Texas A&M. So Baylor's my best bet here on the show. My best bet this week, though, is my college mismatch of the year. This is one of my two strongest plays of the entire season that I give out. It is a personal service exclusive. Can't buy it online. It's not going to be available that way. The whole thing starts with another TV triple header, and it's three outstanding games. South Carolina, Florida, Utah, Notre Dame, USC, Arizona. All three of those games are free on tape at 1-888-633-1710. Plus, I'll tell you how to get my mismatch of the year, and I will tell you that it is, without question, the strongest individual game spot I've seen all season in college or pro football. 1-888-633-1710 for the TV triple header, free on tape right now. Al?
Well, I'm going to agree with Dave here. My best bet's going to be the Baylor Bears. Your best bet is to get on board for my NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. This play out of an incredible 25-0 system that's never lost in 31 seasons. And the 26th win in a row is just $25. That's right. It's $500 online, but for ProLine TV viewers, just $25. Call right now toll-free, 866-896-1628. Our ProLine TV offers this year, 10-1 with a push, 91%. And hey, the one loss should have won as well. We're going to win this one. Call right now toll-free, 866-896-1628. Just $25. It's $500 online. You get it for just $25. Our NFL Fortune 500 Club Game of the Year. 866-896-1628. Call now.
Thanks, Al. I'm going to go with the Minnesota Vikings. Brett Favre against Jay Cutler. The offensive line for Minnesota is much better than the offensive line for Chicago. Minnesota wins this one going away. Now, your best bet? Last week I told you I was going to go 3-0 on my promo right here on the show, and I did. I had Navy a winner, Arkansas a winner, Arizona, Stanford over the total a winner. Three big games, all won. So you want to be on board with me this week. I've got five big games. That's right, five big games, $5. That's $1 a game. Just make the phone call right now, 1-866-841-1655. And don't forget, if you want free winners each and every day, text to your phone. Just text WINNER, W-I-N-N-E-R, to 313131, and each and every day we'll send you free winners right to your telephone. That's WINNER to 313131. You want to get on those five big games? Make the call right now, 1-866-841-1655. Stay with all of our best bets each and every week. We win. And make sure you come back next week for more winners and more football.